There are a few names in the camera industry that conjure up more fond feelings than the name Contax. With a wild story that ties together some of the most iconic photography companies in the world, in Germany and Japan, Contax is a company with a history like no other. Today, let's take a look at Kendall Jenner's favorite camera company. That's not a good way to sell this, is it? Kodak has George Eastman, but another name for the film photography Mount Rushmore is one Oscar Barnack. The story of Contax can't be told without telling the story of old Oscar. Oscar Barnack was born on November the 1st, 1879 in Lino, Germany. That's probably not the right way to say that. He showed an early interest in engineering and photography. I love it when these famous people, they always say they had an interest in something academic. I was busy watching SpongeBob and eating SpaghettiOs, but I digress. Anyway, Oscar's talents led him to work for Ernst Lutz Optische Werke. Did that sound German? Sorry. I'm sorry, German people who are watching. I apologize. But anyway, that's Ernst Lutz Optical Works, which is a German optics company. It was at Lutz that Barnack's innovative ideas started to take shape. And that brings us to the invention of the Leica camera. Barnack's most notable contribution to photography was the invention of the Leica camera. In the early 20th century, cameras were large, cumbersome outfits, right? They're really big, boxy things. And the photographic plates used were also bulky and God knows, very difficult to have to manage. Having to actually apply the chemicals to the glass plates yourself to be able to take an image with it eventually. Barnack thought that all of those big, boxy camera designs sucked, so he sought to create a more portable, compact camera that would use a much smaller format of film. His first prototype, the weirdly named Leica, was developed around 1913 and used 35mm cinema film in horizontal orientation. 35mm film being the format of the Leica camera was very important because it allowed the camera to use the more convenient, more widely available movie film format. And this was instead of the jank fest that was all the other film formats floating around at the time. And the camera was in no uncertain terms a breakthrough, as it offered high image quality in a small and lightweight package. Film was cheaper and more accessible, which led to the Leica, the Leica camera, being a success. The Leica camera evolved from Barnack's prototype, and it was introduced into the market in 1925 and gained widespread acclaim for many of the things that we just talked about, for its innovative design, exceptional optics, and that convenient 35mm format. Leica's 35mm format became the standard for small format photography worldwide, revolutionizing the way the photographs were taken and making photography more accessible to a wider audience. Old man Eastman will get the credit for inventing film, but it was really Oscar Barnack who did a lot to get the film into the hands of everyday people. So we've spent a lot of time talking about Oscar Barnack. Let's talk about his involvement with Contax. So this video is about Contax. Why are we talking so much about old Oscar? Well, just settle down. We're getting to that. Barnack's association with the Contax camera series came through his collaboration with a company with the best name, at least in my opinion, the best name in the world, and that's Zeiss Ikon. Zeiss Ikon was a German camera manufacturer formed from the merger of various optics companies and camera companies. Zeiss Ikon aimed to create a camera that could rival the achievements of the Leica. To make that so, Zeiss brought Barnack on board to contribute his expertise. Oscar Barnack had joined Zeiss Ikon and played a pivotal role of shaping the Contax I. This collaboration not only brought together the expertise of two pioneering figures in photography, but also contributed to the growth of the entire camera industry, so it was a very important collaboration. At the time, it wasn't easy to go out and just buy a camera that didn't suck. There were lots of dogs out there. These early German cameras did well to make photography more comprehensible to the average person. The year 1932 marked a significant milestone. It was the year they first unveiled the Contax camera, the Contax I. This camera was a rangefinder and it was aimed squarely at competing with the iconic Leica design. The camera immediately turned the heads of the photography world. Crafted with precision and outfitted with superior Carl Zeiss lenses, the Contax I was not just a camera, it was a statement of Zeiss Ikon's ambition to challenge the established norms and become a dominant force in the global film landscape. Talking a little bit about the Contax I more specifically, the Contax I holds a significant place in the history of photography as one of the pioneering 35mm rangefinder cameras. The Contax I marked the company's entry into the realm of high-quality compact cameras and set the stage for a new era of photography. Its significance can be understood through its innovative features, its impact on the industry, and its lasting legacy. Some of the most innovative features of the camera, much like the Leica, it used that 35mm cinema film. That was the big change, right? Previously, we had had large format cameras, big boxy things. Now we're in a world where we're dealing with smaller, more usable cameras that shoot that 35mm cinema film. The camera incorporated a rangefinder focusing mechanism, which allowed photographers to accurately measure the distance between the camera and the subject, thereby achieving critical focus. This single innovation was a game changer for street and candid photography, as well as for capturing scenes in difficult lighting situations. You're able to actually figure out exactly what you were shooting at instead of just using the focusing
scales.
The Contax was Zeiss PlayStation to Leica's Nintendo. The Contax I was developed with a specific goal in mind, to rival the prominence of the Leica camera. The introduction of the Contax I sparked a healthy rivalry between Contax and Leica. And this was good for both companies as it led to lots of innovations and advancements in camera design, lens quality, and features. The mid-1930s saw the evolution of the Contax lineage with the introduction of the Contax II, and then after that, the Contax III. These models not only refined the concepts of their predecessors, but they also introduced advancements like the enhanced rangefinder mechanism, and then on the Contax III, a lot meter. The Contax II was historic and highly regarded camera by Zeiss as well. It was a rangefinder camera, once again, also 35mm. The camera was introduced in 1936 and gained a reputation for its precision engineering and exceptional build quality. If you read reviews about the Contax II, the camera has been celebrated for its meticulous build quality and craftsmanship. These things are supposed to be built like tanks. The camera was constructed with a robust, all-metal body. Contax III was introduced in the mid-1930s. It was built upon the legacy of its predecessors, incorporating advanced features that made it a favorite among photographers at the time. As we talked about just a second ago, the big innovation with the Contax III was the light meter, but also the introduction of the Contax bayonet mount. This bayonet mount facilitated quicker and more secure changes compared to the earlier screw mount designs. Just like the Leica, they had the twisty screw mount designs. The new Contax III bayonet mount turned it and it clicked and it was very secure. It's awesome. These cameras, the Contax I, the Contax II, the Contax III, they solidified Contax's reputation as a formidable contender in the world of rangefinder cameras. But it was the Contax III that would serve as a bridge between the earlier Contax models and the later SLR designs that would become a hallmark of the brand. Well, after three really successful camera releases, one would think that it'd be smooth sailing for Contax, right? Be off to the races. Well, wrong. A little thing called the Second World War broke out, and it just so happened that Germany and Japan, two of the major photographic hubs, were on the wrong team. All that's to say that the tumultuous era of World War II cast a shadow over the camera industry. Zeiss Ikon's operations were disrupted, its facilities damaged, and its aspirations temporarily put on hold. As the war ended and Germany was divided among the victors, the Zeiss Ikon factory found itself situated in East Germany, while a new chapter for Contax was about to unfold in the West. The division led to the establishment of two separate entities, each with different and distinct design philosophies. The East German Zeiss Ikon continued to produce cameras under its original name. Meanwhile, the West German company, based in Stuttgart, embraced the Contax brand. Throughout the 1950s and 60s, continued to solidify its reputation by producing outstanding single-lens reflex cameras, boasting cutting-edge features, superior lenses, and innovative designs. These cameras found favor among photographers and enthusiasts alike, and they're actually still sought after. So, after the Second World War, a few Contax cameras were produced at the original Dresden factory, and some were assembled at the Zeiss Optical Works in Jena. During the war years, the chief designer Herbert Nerwin tried to convert the Contax into a single-lens reflex camera, an SLR, but he was hindered by the presence of the upper roller and the vertical plane shutter. So those rangefinder-specific designs kept the Contax from being able to be adapted into an SLR. Post-war design chief Wilhelm Weisenberg started with a clean slate, and that camera eventually became the Contax S. And the S obviously stood for Spiegelreflex. And the Contax S was absolutely legendary. This camera was said to be the camera that defined the configuration of the modern 35mm film camera. Not only did it introduce the M42 lens mount, which became an industry standard, but it also was equipped with a horizontal focal plane shutter. The camera also employed a pentaprism, so when you looked into the camera, you saw an unreversed image in real time of what your picture was going to be. Pretty darn handy. Introduced in 1949, the S was followed by numerous models, including the D, E, F, FB, FM, FBM. Which all I can only assume stood for very glorious and fine things. And one of the primary reasons they released this camera was presumably so that they could pay their bills, just like me. And as a result of that, this video has been sponsored by Orico. I may be a creator, but I'm also an idiot, especially as it relates to the way that I've been managing my data for the past few years. When Orico reached out to me to offer and let me try one of their storage solutions, I was super excited and I was all too happy to accept. Sad to say that I had been storing every single piece of data that I owned on an external hard drive, which is not great. Orico is a company that specializes in making hard drive enclosures that can house one drive or even several, like the one that I have here. But it's not only hard drives and hard drive enclosures that they make, but they also make lots of other computer accessories as well. One of the best aspects of their products is just how high the build quality is. You can take a look at this thing. It's all made out of solid aluminum. Absolutely love it. In addition to the hard drive enclosures, they make USB hubs, SSDs, disk drives, and lots of other tech products that will help take your data management and computing to the next level. And I'd be tickled if you'd take a look at their products through the link in my description. But back to the video. During that period, VEB Zeiss Ikon, which that's what the company was formally called at the time, was gradually under pressure from Zeiss Ikon AG in the US zone. Again, getting back to that World War II division. So the original Zeiss Ikon and Contax names and trademarks gradually disappeared and were replaced by the name Pentacon, which was a name that I'd never heard of until making this video. And finally, the camera line was abandoned. With the emergence of the Japanese camera industry, mainly a consequence of US pressure on West Germany's Zeiss to cease collaboration with the East German Zeiss, and also the lack of raw materials the former was enduring, it was in a way forced to form an alliance with the Japanese manufacturer. Asahi was the parent company of a little-known brand called Pentax, and the partnership with Asahi and Zeiss Ikon led to the formation of a common mount. It represented a shift away from Asahi Pentax using the M42 Leica mount to using their own proprietary, they called it the Pentax mount, and that mount eventually became known as the Pentax K mount, which we still talk about some today. Another important partnership in Contax's history, though, was their partnership with Yashica. The partnership between Contax and Yashica is an interesting chapter in the history of photography that brought together two distinct camera brands with different strengths and backgrounds. The partnership primarily revolved around Yashica's manufacturing capabilities and Contax's reputation for high-quality optics, resulting in the production of cameras that bore the Contax Yashica C/Y lens mount. Several camera models were produced under the Contax Yashica partnership, including both SLR and rangefinder designs. A few notable cameras that sprung from that partnership included the Contax RTS, which was introduced in 1975. This was one of the flagship models of the partnership. It was a 35mm SLR camera with advanced features for the time, including TTL metering, motorized film advance, among other things. Another important Contax Yashica camera that was introduced in 1994, and this was the Contax RX, which is another notable model, featuring autofocus capabilities in addition to the C/Y lens mount, and a camera that I've reviewed on this channel before, the Contax G1, and its successor, the Contax G2. These were wonderful, fully automatic rangefinder designs. They didn't use the C/Y mount, they used their own proprietary lens mount. These cameras were stuffed full of modern day technology and conveniences, and absolutely looked great. The partnership between Contax and Yashica resulted in the creation of cameras that aimed to offer both optical excellence and advanced features. The Contax Yashica cameras provided an alternative for photographers who sought quality optics, the Zeiss name, without the Leica price tag. However, by the late 20th century and early into the 2000s, digital photography was rapidly gaining momentum and traditional film-based cameras were facing significant challenges. And unfortunately, the Contax Yashica partnership was not immune to those challenges, and it resulted in their demise. The end of the Contax company marked an important chapter in the history of photography. Rooted in the legacy of precision engineering and optical excellence of the German companies, Contax cameras had once graced the hands of photographers worldwide. It was a name that anybody in and around the photography scene was well familiar with. In an era where film photography had reigned supreme for decades, the advent of digital photography disrupted the industry. Digital cameras promised instant results, flexibility, and a departure from the constraints of rolls of film and darkrooms. This shift marked a seismic transition, one that would profoundly impact manufacturers who had built their entire brands and their entire companies on traditional film-based cameras. The Contax company found itself at a crossroads. The allure of digital photography captured the collective imaginations of photographers, and the tide wouldn't be held back for long. The challenging landscape introduced fierce competition into the marketplace from the likes of Canon and Nikon, as well as newcomers boasting innovative digital offerings. Financial challenges further compounded the company's struggles. Fluctuations in the market and the costs associated with maintaining a high level of quality and innovation began to take their toll. The resources needed to sustain the craftsmanship and precision that had defined Contax as a brand were stretched very thin and made it difficult to keep pace with the demands of the digital age. As the years rolled on, the last Contax film-based camera clicked shut, marking the end of a poignant era. The legacy of Contax cameras continued to live on in the hearts of photographers and collectors, a testament to the craftsmanship and the brilliance that had characterized the brand. My time with the Contax G1, one of my favorite cameras of all time, a camera that I regret selling to this day. And I think as this channel goes on, as I continue making videos, there's probably coming a time where I'm not going to be able to resist the urge to buy a Contax G2. But I digress. These cameras, they're wonderful. If you have the opportunity to buy a Contax or shoot a Contax, you'll remember it. They're wonderful cameras. The end of the Contax company serves as a reminder that the world of technology, change is constant and often unyielding. And whether you like it or not, many of these changes are coming. And that's something that's important to remember as we stand at another crossroads with AI. The Contax story underscores the importance of adapting to evolving trends embracing innovation and meeting shifting demands of consumers, or else you're going to be left behind. Your company's going to be shutting the doors. While the traditional contacts companies that once existed may have faded into the annals of history, its impact still lingers on, a testament to the brand that once held a special place in the hearts of photographers, capturing moments that transcended time and giving photographers cameras that outkick their coverage in terms of build quality and image quality. The legacy contacts lies in its contribution to the evolution of photography as an art form and its impact on camera design and technology. While the traditional contacts companies cease production, its influence endures through the lenses it crafted, the designs it pioneered, and the memories it created for generations of photographers. Man, that feels cliche. Contax remains a symbol of innovation and craftsmanship that continues to be celebrated by the film photography community, one of my favorite camera companies of all time. If you think this really long video about Contax is cool, check out my really long film photography iceberg video before you go. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching. That's the history of Contax.